Hello, my cute buddies. I'm your English ma'am. I'm happy to come up with an interesting session. Today, we are going to learn the grammar part of the lesson, The Missing Trinkets, Part 6. Before that, we have a quick recap of yesterday's session, children. May. What is a may? I already told you, may is a modal verb. In the previous session, we have seen so many models. Now, we are going to learn about may and how we can use the may in sentence. It is used to express possibility, permission. So, may is used to express possibility and permission. Okay, children? Now, here is an activity for you. You can think and write in your studio. Work in pairs. Enact each of these situations. Demonstrate how you can be polite in each. Discuss possibilities and reasons for each situation. Write your responses on each briefly. One has been done for you. So they have given you situation. So in our lifetime, we have met lot of situations. So how we can react for the situation, that is very important. Here also they have given you some situation, how you can react for the situation using may. Are you ready, children? So one example has been done for you. You are late to school. You are standing at the entrance of your think room. What will you ask your teacher before you enter? So this is a situation for you, and your response is, may I come in, ma'am? See why we are using a question mark? I already told you, once you are getting permission from someone, we can use question mark. Next, you are going to give the reason for the late. I'm sorry for being late. I was caught in a big traffic jam on the way. It may have been because of minister's arrival. So, we are giving our response and we are explaining the reason why we are coming late today. So, these are the situation and you have to respond for the situation. So, likewise, some more situation has been given for you. You have to read and respond for the situation. Write this in sentence using may. And your second situation is, you forgot to bring your pen and pencil to class. You want to borrow one from your friend. How will you ask them? So this is the situation. Usually we know every time we can forget to bring certain things to school. It may be your box, your water bottle, your pencil, your tiffin box, whatever it may be. So in that circumstance, how we can respond? We definitely getting help from our friends. So likewise, how you can get help from your friends using may? Can you write this, children? Try to write. Let me check your answer. Finished, children? Now here is the answer for you. May I borrow your pencil? Very good, children. See, at the end of the sentence we are marking here question mark. Okay, permission, while we are asking permission, we should apply here question mark. May I borrow your pencil? Or you can write, may I borrow your pen, may I borrow your eraser, whatever. What thing you have not brought to the school, that thing you can get from your friends. Now your next situation is, you have completed the home fun and other chores for the day. You want to go out and play with your friends. How will you ask your parents? So that is your situation. See, in that day you have completed all of your home fun and all of your activities. Now your friends are waiting for you and you want to go out and play with your friends. How you can get permission from your parents? That is the situation for you. Can you write the answer, children? Let me check your answer. Yes. May I go out and play with my friends? So this is the response for that situation. Now, your next situation is, your father is stepping out to the market. You would like him to carry an umbrella as there is a possibility of rain. How will you tell him what you think? See, during the rainy season, it is usual. Now, it is a rainy season. Whenever we are going out, we should carry an umbrella. Now, in the situation, your father is going out to purchase something from the market. So, for that time, how you can remind your father to take the umbrella? It may be rain. Ready, children? Have you finished? Let me check your answer. Father, you may carry an umbrella. Keep this in your mind. Father, you have to mark your comma. Father, just comma. You may carry an umbrella. So, it may be rain. So, you have to carry an umbrella. So, this is the response for the situation, children. Now, here is a summary for you. You have to write the function. Write the two different ways in which may is used. In your own words, give two examples for each in complete sentences. So, you have know the function of may. You have two functions. One function, what is a function? May can be used to convey possibility. Repeat after me, children. May can be used to convey possibility. Now, you have to write example for this. Tina may come home today. See, it may be possibility of Tina to come home today. You can write this second example also by home. You can write whatever. So, you have to use the may. And the second function of may. What is the second function? Yes, may can be used to grant and seek permission. As you know very well, getting permission, we are using here question mark. Very good, children. Come on, repeat this after me, children. May can be used to grant or seek permission. P-E-R-M-I-S-S-I-O-N, permission. May can be used to convey possibility. P-O-S-S-I-B-I-L-I-T-Y, possibility. Okay, children. Now, here is the examples for you. May I borrow your pencil? May I borrow your book? May I borrow your eraser? This may be the permission. So, at the end of the sentence, we should mark your question mark. Whenever there is a possibility, we should mark here full stop. Whenever there is a permission, we should mark here question mark. Are you understood this, children? Okay. You can write the second examples. Okay. This may be your homework today. Now, here is a companion activity for you. You can all take your companion, sit and read this. Helping verb may. I already told you may is a helping verb. Read the sentences in column A and column B. Match the situation with the correct question using may. Column A, column B. May I drink some water? So this is a question. When we supposed to drink water? When we feel thirst. Yes, here is the answer. I am thirsty. So, when I feel thirst, I may use this. May I drink some water? Okay, next one. May I come in? May I come in? So, when you enter into a room, we should ask this permission, may I come in? Now, tell me, when you can use this question? Here is the answer for you, children. I am thirsty. May I drink some water? May I come in? I need to see Aisha. So you want to see Aisha, so you are asking permission. May I come in? May I go outside and play? When you can ask this question, I am bored. When I am getting bored, I usually go out and play with my friends. So that you are asking this permission. May I borrow your pencil? When we are asking this question, yes, I do not have a pencil. If I don't have a pencil, I can use this question to my friend. May I borrow your pencil? Next, may I eat the ice cream? When I feel to eat an ice cream, I am hungry. When I'm hungry, I can ask this question. May I eat the ice cream? Have you understand this, children? So, this is the exercise. You have to write this in your companion book. Now, your next exercise. Rewrite the sentences and questions in the correct order using may. One has been done for you. Come, we in play. Here the words are not arranged in proper way. You have to arrange this in proper way and make a complete sentence. Okay, children? Come we in May. So here we can make a correct form of sentence. May we come in? So here we are using a question mark. May play friends I my with. How we can use this? Here is the answer for you. May I play with my friends? You can put here question mark. Rain it today may. Can you guess the answer for this? Yes, very good. It may rain today. Observe here, we are using here full stop. It is a possibility. Borrow your iBook may. Have you formed the correct sentence? Very good. May. May I borrow your book? Keep one thing in your mind. Whenever we are asking permission, may should be the first word. And we are getting a possibility. Whenever there is a possibility, and may must be the second word. That you can keep this in your mind. These are some keys. Evening at home, may Rakesh be this? Here is the answer. Rakesh may be this evening at home. Okay? So this is the possibility. So we are applying here full stop. Paintbrush I use may your. Okay? This is the permission you are asking. Yes, this is the answer. May I use your paintbrush? Copy this answer in your companion book, children. Now, your next exercise. Look at the following pictures. Write sentences of your own to describe what may happen in each picture. Okay? You can look at this picture. One girl is riding bicycle and her name is Radha. And what they have mentioned, stone is there and the puddle. What do you mean by puddle, children? A small pool of liquid, especially of rain water on the ground. You know very well now it is a rainy season. We can see lot of puddles on the roadside. Okay? It especially rain water, surface with water or rain water. So, how you can alert the girl? You can write your sentence using may. It may be the possibility. See, the stones are there, the puddle is there. If she ride like this, what will happen? She may drop into the puddle or she may get hurt. How you can make this sentence? Here is the answer for you. Radha may drop her bicycle into the puddle. Okay? He can drop her bicycle into the puddle. Next. Now see the next picture. Here's Ramesh. Banana peel is there. He's walking fastly. What will happen in the situation? How you can make the sentence using may? If he walk fast, what will happen? Yes, he may fall down. This is also a possibility. So how we can write this? Ramesh may slip down. Ramesh may slip down. Okay, children. Next. See, what you can see in this picture? See the clouds. The clouds are there. The clouds are dark. Lot of gray clouds. So if the clouds are dark, what it will be? Yes, it may be rain. So this is the answer for you, children. It may rain this evening. So this is the possibility. Now next, see this picture. The girl is standing outside the classroom. The class is going on. The teacher is teaching something. The student requesting permission. So whenever you go out and enter into our class, how you can seek permission? You are usually doing this. And you children, you are specially very fond of this. You are going out and entering into the class. How you can seek permission? Yes. May I come in, ma'am? May I come in, sir? Okay. So you can use here question mark. Now, see the next picture. One girl is holding heavy weight on her hand. Mother carrying heavy bags. Okay? Holding lot of bags. What will happen? Possibilities. Can you guess? Can you able to write this? Yes. Mother may get tired. If you are holding this much of heavy bags, you are feeling really tired. Okay? See, the mother also getting tired. So we write like this. Mother may get tired. So thank you, children. Meet you in the next session. I hope everyone should write these answers in your companion book as well as in your studio books. Learn and write the answers in your notebooks, children. Okay? Thank you. Bye. Meet you in the next session.